So, since I've had my truck, the Taco Supreme, as it has been named, not by me, but by a buddy, it doesn't have an armrest, and I kind of wanted an armrest, also like center console in it, a little more storage, locking storage in the truck. I had an ammo can, and I set it here, and went, wow, this is perfect, I must do this. That's exactly what I thought, probably. So I bought some hardware and I've been fabbing it up and it actually works. So let me walk you through it. So it's just a 50 cal ammo can. I don't have it all complete yet. It is bolted through the seat. I will flip it over and show you how I did it, what hardware I use, but 50 cal can, four holes, four bolts, and I do have a lock. Conversion for it. I don't have a lock on it yet. So, still locks. Armrest. I found this on Amazon. And it's padded. And it's like, it wasn't designed for ammo cans, but I mean, it's perfect. It's great. Like, I don't know what else I'd use it for, but it's perfect. So, mounting it, you want to leave a space here, or I left a space so when this is open, it actually stays open. If you mount this too far back, it's going to be right here. It's going to hit, and it's not even going to open up all the way. So, to put this on, I'm using some 3M tape. I think that should hold it. And then inside the can, I have these dividers. They come in a three pack from the same website. So that's how they work. Pops in. And there she goes. Sorry if things are out of frame. I'm not looking at the camera too much. So that's roughly it. I did, before I even put the can on the seat, I did have the seat in the truck and I set the can down, put my arm on it and went, yeah, this is happening. This is perfect. So I sourced this. This was $13, $14, something like that. The locks, you can get these for five to 10, somewhere in there. They're relatively cheap. The can, I already had the can. Cans are like 20, 25 bucks, somewhere in there. The dividers, I don't remember what I paid for these. $15, $16, somewhere in there. So I was trying to do the whole thing at a $50 budget, minus the can, because I already had the can. It was given to me. So the hardware is going to run from a local hardware store. The hardware is like 20 bucks. From Home Depot, it's $5 for the hardware. So here's what I got. So there's a hex bolt. I'd recommend a 4-inch or longer to start, but you're gonna end up cutting a bunch of it off. It's got to be at least 4 inches long to reach through the seat to grab onto the retaining nut. The hex nut, you're gonna need. Oh, I use eight of them, so this is probably gonna run you more than $5 for the hardware. I had extras. So the hex nuts, yeah, four bolts, eight nuts, you want to double up on it. So there's a flat washer, a 3/4 inch. I'll show you, that's a giant one. The first time I went around, I bought these other flat washers. The code was UDA and also ASC, so four of each. One is larger than the other. You will see in a minute why I use that. So four of each for mounting. And it's pretty easy. Once I got the bolts through, I hacked them shorter. But yeah, 3-inch will be very difficult to do. It is possible, but on the front of the seat, you gotta have at least 5 inches would be great to start. Four works if you really push it through. So let me flip this upside down and I will show you what I'm talking about. Alright, well, it's not upside down, but you get the picture. So, as you can see, the nuts are doubled up, because if you push on the ammo can, you can rock it, because it is just squeezing foam on here. You can rock it, and it will loosen this up, so double up on the nuts if you're going to do that. So what was really convenient, that I didn't know until I got the seat out the bench, was it had these four holes already here. That's perfect. Just get some big washers for it. So here's a smaller one, which wasn't quite enough. Wasn't enough to grab onto everything. And then I got the bigger one for the rest of it. So mounting, it's like it was meant to be. Everything is pretty simple. I had a plate, a metal plate I was preparing to... I thought it was just like this in the center, but it wasn't. I was preparing to get a plate, put a plate over this, and run all four bolts into the plate. And then just use that to retain it, but I didn't have to. It's just coming out like this. It's not perfect, but it's pretty good. So it's not too much fabricating you have to do. Just drilling holes in the ammo can. So, ammo can, center console, and a bench seat Tacoma. This one's a 98. So what is that? First gen, second gen Tacoma? I'm not an expert on these things, but the early Tacomas, yeah, if you have a bench seat like this, you can do it for, I mean, without the dividers and without the armrest. I mean, that was an extra 30, 35 bucks for the dividers and the armrest. And if you go without the lock, that's $40 less. Then you're just at the cost of the ammo can and the hardware. So, making it not look like you have an ammo can in the center of your seat, you can repaint it, or I was thinking getting some fabric, some cloth, and wrapping that around it and gluing it on. I'm probably not going to do that. Another route is easy, cheap, getting a decorative duct tape and just wrapping the whole thing in duct tape. I'm probably just going to go that route. Then, if I don't like it, I can take it off. And if it gets scratched, I can take it off. It's easy to repair and replace, because this truck is a daily driver. It is a work truck. I mean, the thing sees about 80 miles a day driving, and sometimes more. It is high mileage, but I do spend a lot of time in this truck. So if you really want to be fancy with it, you can drill a hole in the back and run 12 volt into it. You know, just run wires under the carpet, under the bench, into the back of it, and then put like a USB port in there for charging, and then run like the auxiliary of the radio in there if you're doing it, if you're not Bluetoothing. I mean, there's a bunch of options you can do with it. I'm just going to leave it as is. I'm going to try putting a divider in there, because if I put something metallic in, it's going to be banging around, making noise. So I'll put one of these in there, try it out, and I'm going to put the cover on at the armrest. Seat is out of the truck. I'm going to vacuum out the truck since I have the seat out. And then maybe I'll make a clip of it all done and in. And final product. But yeah, that's basically it. It's pretty simple. Just four bolts, eight nuts, eight washers, drill the holes in the can. Okay, so I probably should mention technique of figuring out where those holes are in the seat. I used a metal rod. I don't know where it is. I used I sharpened this stainless steel rod, a nice sharp point, and I basically just fished it through here, shoved it through, and when it gets to the cloth, that cloth is actually pretty stout. So you really gotta force it or hit a hammer or something. So I poked through, saw where the holes were, and I cut out a cardboard template of the bottom of the ammo can, placed it on top of there, and saw roughly where the holes were. Well, I also had the ammo can. First, I set the ammo can on top of the seat, and I lined it with tape so I would see a window of where I want the holes to be. So I got that out of there. Set the can on there, ran the tape around it, took the can off, shoved this through to see where it would be, and then wherever this went through, I marked it with a Sharpie, and I put the cardboard on it, ran this through the hole again onto the cardboard, poked holes in the cardboard, put the cardboard on the bottom of the can, marked the holes with a Sharpie, drilled it, and the seat, so the seat had the holes, so I had the holes marked with the Sharpie on here. So I took a drill bit, and I ran it in reverse. If you go forwards, it's just going to grab the cloth, and it's not going to be pretty. A large drill bit, ran it in reverse, and it was enough to tear up the cloth, just enough to fish the bolts all the way through. This is my first time doing something like this. If you can come up with a better way, by all means, go for it. That's just the way I did. But fishing through the seat, sharpened rod. A nail would work good too. A long nail would be great for it. You sharpen it, but this is what I used. Your results may vary. Another solution is just buy a bench seat from I think the four-wheel drives or the extended cabs have armrests, but they don't have a center console to them. Or just taking out the bench seat and putting in buckets and then bolting your ammo can to the floor, to the transmission tunnel. But then it's going to be too low for using as an armrest. But I don't know, there's ways around it. You can put spacers in there and shit. I was rambling on. Easy project. Getting the seat out, I think it's a 14 millimeter, 14 or 15 mil, something like that. I think it's a... Yeah, it's a 14 mil. I just looked at the socket. So 14 mil. There's four bolts. Two facing back from the front. And then two on the back side facing down. I'd say slide this. Take off the ones on the front. Like slide the seat all the way back. Pull off the ones on the front. And then slide the seat forward. And then I'll give you clearance to pull these ones straight up. So it's pretty easy. Alright, that's enough talking. This video is getting long. It's like 13 minutes. Well, as you can tell, I got the seat in, so there's something I overlooked, but not a big deal, and that's folding the seat forward. But that's okay. If I take off the lid to the ammo can, I mean, the seat folds forward just fine. So there is another detail. Why this might not work in your truck as well as it does in mine. Like, see it? I can shift it just fine from right here. But you might notice that throw is really short. I do have an LC Engineering short throw shift kit, which takes out 60% of the shift throw distance. And it also raises the shifter up, I think, like an inch and a half. I'm not sure exactly. So my shifter is raised up from stock height, and it is also a very short throw. So if your application is a manual transmission, good luck. I mean, another alternative is you can cut the seat out and then just bolt the ammo can directly to the seat without the foam in it. I mean, that would work too. Just depends on the condition of your seat and everything if you really want to do that. But yeah, I have a short throw shift kit in this, so it's pretty short. But yeah, I mean, it's for me, it's perfect. You know, that's why I did it. You just shift right here. Anyways, gonna wrap up the video. This video is getting really long for something that's really simple. If you have any questions and crap like that, throw it in the comments, or I'll put my Instagram for the truck builds and shit, whatever I do with this. I'll put the Instagram for that in the description. Yeah. Thanks for watching, and, have fun with whatever you're doing.